That's some statue. Who built it, Ethan?
I do not know.
So, know any good stories to pass the time?
What kind of story?
I don't know. Mother always had stories. Weren't you told any when you were a boy?
There was a man I knew of long ago. His stories were brief and purposeful.
Sounds fun. Do you remember any?
There was one that concerned a hare and a tortoise.
Like the witch's house?
Unlikely.
So what happens?
They wager on a race between them. The hare is too confident of victory and foolish, while the tortoise is steady and disciplined. The tortoise wins.
You haven't told a lot of stories, have you? Huh?
The water dropped.
And the serpent rose. Right. I knew that. I know she's really powerful, but you really think the witch can bring a head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft. And we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No. But you may feed it to the fish.
Okay. And now the door's gone. The witch's turtle must be standing up. So how do we get back up there?
Ha ha ha!
are done here.
I bet this will lead out. Turn back, Aesir. Yes. The gods aren't welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
She is here.
It is so good to see you again. I knew you weren't dead.
Hello.
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now.
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. What's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please? Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Have I taught you nothing, boy?
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple.
Only the last living giant in Midgard. You better tell us the way.
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to her?
Indeed.
He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
Who?
It's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Speak to the serpent.
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I haven't seen new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there. Tyr's braziers, a symbol of the light that binds all realms together.
Why would he use those strange runes, though?
Now you mention it, he wouldn't.
Almost. If we could just find the other pieces of the language disc. Getting a letter here and there, but we need the rest of the language disc. So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
nightmares. Ugh, what awful pain.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Ready yourself, boy!
Among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in peace.
You want us to...
Gulvig?
Really?
Boy.
I can smell...
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken 3 of sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
while
we...
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once, named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night, feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. And look, he fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ballbag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Please give the word.
Giant chisel. Magically sealed, I'm afraid.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Trick lad.
Thanks.
To the survivors. Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything. Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
I'll find Light Crystal. That's Andy. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down? How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Ready.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a wall stone?
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward?
Right here!
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
Another crystal. Just give the word. Huh. What now? Most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do? Why are we going up when what we need is all the way down there?
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
Going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip.
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck then.
You are welcome to suggest a different one. Hold tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Wait. Jump!
That didn't work. It only fell a little ways.
Come on.
Oh, no. Oh, the floor's collapsed. There's a sand bowl. But how do we get to it?
We cannot.
Nova! No!
Boy. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used to sing.
Do I know that one? Winter, that...
Quiet, Head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it.
There.
Vaur, Haust, Vetter, Sumar. Nuh-uh, that wasn't right.
There.
Vaur, Haust, Vetter, Sumar. Still nothing.
Boy, the order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Do it.
Vetter, Sumar, Vaur, Haust.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed. Try that.
Vetter. Sumar. Vetter. House.
The riddle. Winter is last.
There you go, brother.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn. Vetter, Vaur, Sumar, Haust. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song Mom sang.
Do it.
Haust, Vaur, Sumar, Vetter. No.
Want me to?
No. I just need quiet. Winter. Last.
You sure you'd...
Quiet. Winter is last. Retrograde. There.
Vaur, Vaur, Sumar, Vetter.
What's more, boy? The song.
Winter, spring.
There.
Vaur, Haust, Sumar, Vetter. I don't think we're ever gonna get this.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn. But reversed. Autumn first, winter last. Do it.
House. Sumo. Bar. Veteran. Yes.
Atreus. That word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Just lifting the platform.
Keep riding.
Thor. Thor. Thor.
Head. How is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them. Always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
I can't get to the pole!
Writing before the floor collapses.
Keep it up!